Hey everybody, it's Eugene Liscio and welcome to Click3D. On this episode, what I'm going to be doing is the on-site compensation for the FARO S350 scanner. And if you don't know what on-site compensation is, it's a way of increasing the accuracy of this scanner by minimizing errors. And the way you do that is by scanning some targets. Now, there are reasons why you may or may not want to do this, and under normal operation, you're going to be fine. You don't have to do this. But there may be situations where you want to get that little bit extra accuracy, or maybe you just want to check the scanner because, I don't know, you've been traveling and it's been rattling around inside of a case and you're checking it in on airplanes and things like that. So it's something that you can do frequently. Like you can do it once every few months, or you can do it, you know, once every couple of weeks if you really want to. But it's a way of quickly checking the scanner. Now, in my case, sometimes I like to do this because I may be working on a research project or something which is just important to me, and I just want to see if I can maximize the accuracy of the scanner. So that's what we're going to be covering today, and I'll get back to it in just a second. I need to set up some things. Be back in a bit. So there's some different things that you need to consider whenever you're going to be doing the on-site compensation. And the way that it works is you have to be in a controlled environment and the scanner needs to be at a stable temperature. Now, if you're going to be scanning in a really cold area and you do this in a warm environment, there's obviously a big difference there. So that's going to change some of the accuracies of the scanner. But let's say I was scanning inside of this room and I'm working on some kind of a project. What I do first is I make sure that the scanner is at a stable temperature. So this scanner has been on already for about an hour. You only need to do like 10-15 minutes, and it usually warms up on the inside. I can feel it's a little bit warm, so that's good. This thing is nice and stable. This is the environment that I would actually be scanning in, so that is what I'm going to be doing. Again, if you're going to be doing the compensation here, but then you're going to go outside and it's below freezing, that's not going to help you. In fact, it could even be detrimental. So keep that in mind. The other thing is the environment, or you know, where you're going to be setting up these targets. And so what I want is a nice flat wall. I need about 2.4 meters from the ground and up to about here. So I have a little stretch here that I'm going to use, and this should be perfectly fine. You're going to be using these targets. I'll talk about these in a second, but the wall needs to be flat, and something like a white wall or just a plain wall is fine. Don't back this onto anything that's like glass or something that is uneven or, you know, has different recesses and things like that. Simple wall and you're going to be fine. Now let's talk about the targets. So the targets is just a plain printed sheet, A4 or letter, and you can get the target pattern inside of the scene software, and I think you can even get it from the knowledge base with FARO. And you print out, you'll need six of these. Now when you print these out, you have to make sure that it's on a laser printer. If you try to do this on an inkjet printer, you may run into some problems. And part of the reason is that the ink isn't detected up in the infrared range. Now the scanner, the laser on the scanner is up at a wavelength of 1550 nanometers. And so if you do this on inkjet, it just looks like a white piece of paper. So you burn it in on a laser jet and you'll be just fine. Now I already got some tape here and I've got some a few more sheets, and I'll talk about the setup for the target sheets in a little bit. The other thing that you're going to need is your laptop, because you have to connect remotely with the laptop using FARO Scene to the scanner. And it's very, very important that you have the latest firmware in the scanner and you have the latest version of FARO Scene. So 2021.1 or higher, you're going to have the latest version of the on-site compensation. Now there is a version of that before and it works a little bit differently. And a couple of things that FARO has done is they've made it more robust and they've made it faster as well. So you're not waiting as long for the on-site compensation to happen. And that's nice when you're in the field, you know, you're not waiting, you know, a lot longer. It's, in fact, I think they've cut it down by about half, if I'm not mistaken. So let's start with the scanner, then we'll talk about the targets, and then I'll show you how to hook it up. So scanner, first things first. Now, if you follow the guide with respect to the scanner, there are optimal distances in terms of height and how far the scanner needs to be from the wall. So I've already got this one set up, but it's going to be approximately 4 feet. So if I look at this and I go here, I see I've got 4 feet. It actually says about 124, and I'm like, you know, about 125. So that's good enough. It doesn't have to be perfect. No problem there. So I have a line right here. This will be my guide where the tripod is, and I'm just gonna move this back. Now also, when you're setting up the tripod, okay, try not to use the center column, okay? Make sure that the scanner is down low on the base, and you know, if you have a beefy tripod, use that one. Don't use a flimsy tripod. This one is fine. I'm on a concrete floor. You need to be on a very, very stable ground. If you're on like a wooden floor that's creaking as you move around or whatever, not a good setup. It needs to be rock solid. So this is going to be absolutely fine. I also need to make sure that the scanner is level. And so what I can do is check that from the top. Actually, you can go into the inclinometer at the top and you can see it here. It's all good to go. Yeah, it's very well aligned there, so no problem there. But if you need to, you can tweak the legs and get it into the position that you need. Now, finally, the distance from the wall is going to be important, okay? So I've got the height, and you want to be about 4.5 feet, okay? About 137 centimeters, so I'm looking at it here, and I actually need to be farther back. So I need to be somewhere around where this line is over here, yeah. So where this line is, so right about there. Okay, so I said over here before, but actually it's back here, so that's not a problem. And I'm pretty much good with the wall here. That's the distance. Center of the mirror is where I'm measuring to. So let's just double check this one more time. And it's almost like 140, so that's okay, close enough. So the scanner is pretty much set up in terms of its height and its distance from the wall. Let's talk about the targets. And I'm going to place the targets. For that, I need to go grab a few more. Okay, so I have prepared some targets already here. And these are just 8.5 by 11 sheets, and they're printed out, and I've got 6 of them in total. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to place these pretty much at the center, and I need to find a spot on the wall here that's actually clear. So starting from the bottom, I've got this outlet here that's in the way, and then kind of going all the way up. So I can fit them in just in between this vent and that outlet, and I'll be fine. But what I'm gonna do is look at the horizontal axis here, and just has to be rough. Let's say somewhere about here, and I wanna make sure that these are looking good vertical, and let me just temporarily put that there. I'm going to need to move this over like that. And if I look at it, I can see that the center of the mirror is about the same height as the sort of the in-between of these two targets here. So that's good. So I'm just going to lock this in place. I'm going to tape these up and make sure that you tape all four corners. You don't want these flopping around. You want them nice and flat. That looks good. Now what I'm going to do is I'm gonna set up the outer target. So the upper target and the lower target. And for that, I need to stretch and I need to make sure that I am somewhere like this. Yeah, that looks more or less perpendicular. So I'm gonna go like that. Okay, that looks pretty good there. Let me put the lower one. So I'm gonna put one at the very bottom. And let me make sure that that looks fairly even, not bad. Now they don't have to be perfect aligned. I can stand back and look at it after, and that's not bad. Okay, not too bad. Could be a little bit better, but it's fine for what we're doing. Okay, now what I'm gonna do is place the in-between targets. And for the in-between targets, I just divide it equally, more or less, make sure that they're in line here like this. So that looks good, and I'm gonna put this bottom middle one right about there, and I think that would be okay. Okay. So there we have it. Just make sure these are all secured. They look good, they're flat, and they're in line. Let me have a look what it looks through here. Not too bad at all. Okay, so again, scanner height, about 4 feet, about 124 centimeters or so. Distance from the scanner to the wall is about 137 centimeters, about 4.5 feet, more or less. And this should give me everything. Spread the targets out, something in this fashion. Again, you need about 2.4 meters, and that's what I have about here, almost bang on. So I should be in pretty good shape. All right, Now what I need to do is I need to set up the laptop, and then we will get the scanner connected and we'll start the process. Be back in a sec. Okay, so I need to get this going here, and I am going to connect to the scanner. So the first thing that I need to do is see if the scanner is broadcasting. So here you'll see it is. This is my scanner. So I'm just going to go ahead and connect. Now, if it's not on in the scanner, you just got to go into the general settings and you'll see the WLAN. You switch it on and you should be fine. So if you don't have, mine's been connecting dozens of times before. So the password, the default password is 0 through 9. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And if you've changed it, then you have to check it on the scanner. Okay, that's good there. Now the IP address, this is the default IP address, 192.168.43.1. That's great. So I'm just gonna say, go ahead and connect. Now here it says already at the top that it is successfully established the connection, and it says, do you want, like, go ahead and place the targets? Well, we've done that already, so it says, okay, this is what you need to do. Now, be careful here, because on this screen, this is a little bit different than the latest that's what's in the knowledge base. So FARO needs to update this this screen, and the description here is a little different, okay? So please keep that in mind if you're running this version. Perhaps in a future version, these screens will be changed. So what we need to do here is, it says, once you finish the preparations, click horizontal alignment. The scanner will then move to a defined horizontal position. So I'm going to go horizontal alignment. And you'll see the scanner is going to go to its home position. Now this is important, and I've angled it on purpose here, so you see that it's not aligned with the wall, okay? So it scans from these two directions, so it's way, way off right now. So what I need to do is I need to align this so that the side here is parallel to the wall, or when I look through it, it's perpendicular to the wall. So basically, I'm going to look through here like this, and I'm going to make sure that I'm almost dead center on the target sheet. That looks pretty good to me. Not too bad. And you don't have to worry about which side, because it's going to scan from both sides anyway, so you'll be absolutely fine. Just make sure you're more or less centered. I could slide this over a tiny bit like that, and I'm going to live with that right there. Okay. So the scanner is in position. Let's continue here. It says scan and compensate. So I'm ready to go. I'm just going to say, boom, go ahead and scan. And now it's just a waiting game. I'm going to let this do its thing. I'm going to get out of the way, and then we'll come back later. Actually, you'll see that the scanner moved, and it's starting on that side of the target. It's going to sweep the target. Then it's going to quickly spin all the way around, and then it's going to do the other side. And it's going to compare the first scan here with the scan from the opposite side. It's really important that there's no wind or anything like that, and that these targets don't move. And the scanner doesn't move either. You'll see now it's quickly moving all the way around. So it's going to spin around and it's going to start scanning from the other side here. So that means it is done scanning, and if I look over here, I'll see that FARO Scene is working on the compensation, so I just need to wait a couple of minutes or so, and once it's done, I'll come back and we'll have a look at the results. Okay, well, it looks like it just finished here, and if we have a look at this screen, you'll see on the left here, it asks whether or not you want to apply the compensation. And then over here, it's the compensation report. Now, if you look here, it says the horizontal error, it says the vertical error, and then it shows you the before and after. So the vertical error was 0.0005, before, it's the same after. If you look at the horizontal error, it was 0.0025, and now it's 0.0011. And so it gives you the total RMS error, so 0.0026 going to 0.0013. Is it a huge improvement? No, not a lot, but it's something that I could consider. And there's a report down here. So if you look down here, it says open report. And if you don't save this report, it's actually stored for you here in this area right over here. So if I click on open report, you'll see that this is what I have. I have this PDF, and it basically just reports back the same numbers that I had just before. So that's cool. So if I want, I can, you know, just go file, save as, and save that somewhere if you want, which is great. The other thing you can do too is, if you click on this link here, it'll open up the place where it keeps all the compensation data. And there's one here that says target image. So I'm gonna open this one up. And you'll see here, this particular image, there's some lines here. There's these horizontal lines. And what's important here is that you have a set of targets below this line here, and on the top line, you have a set of targets which is above. Okay, now you'll see I have a little bit more room here to stretch this out a little bit. So in terms of height, you can see I have a little bit more space up here, which would have been good. So the farther that I stretch these out, the better it will be for me. But this is perfectly acceptable. You can see I have one above. You can see I have one, the majority of it below, just touching there, but no big deal. That will still work. I also have a copy of the report here, the PDF report that I just opened, and that's something that you can always go back to, and if you'll have the path that's over here if you want it. Now, over here where it says apply the compensation, if I want to, I can. I'll just click on finish, okay, and it says compensation applied, and then that is pretty much it. So that's the on-site compensation. Now, for a lot of people, it might have been a little bit of a mystery, or maybe it's a feature that you knew about, but you thought, geez, I don't want to touch that because I might screw something up. There's really not a lot that you can damage unless you really mess it up. It's either going to work or it's going to fail. And if it fails, it's probably something with your scanner placement or your target placement. So you just have to check that, follow the instructions properly. Also, remember that it's really important to have the latest firmware version and the latest software. And if you do that, you'll benefit from the latest version of the on-site compensation. It's more robust, works a little bit faster. And remember to get the scanner or have the scanner warm up, okay? It's good to give it like 15 minutes, just leave it on, let everything stabilize and come to a decent temperature. Also, the environment I'm in is controlled, right? So it's not a heavily swinging, I'm not going into a freezer and then coming out or whatever. It may sound obvious, but if you're in a controlled environment, then that's a little bit better. So if you had to do this outside though, let's say you're gonna start a job or a project outside, that might be a little bit more challenging. And part of the reason is you have to find a flat surface, you have to let things stabilize. It's not impossible, but you have to really consider whether or not there's gonna be the benefit, if it's gonna be worth it to run the on-site compensation. Okay, that's it. I wanna thank everybody for watching Click 3D. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.